Hello everyone, welcome back. Today I got two cool things that I want to show you guys, and I have some pretty cool friends. Basically, you know, I got hooked up with some of these items here, and I'll tell you the story behind these guys. The first thing is my buddy who works with me, he actually had a Game Boy Color, and for some reason it was not turning on, so I told him that I'd go ahead and take a look at it and everything. And I, like, if I get a used system or whatever, you know, I went through the phases of, you know, like, doing restoration on it and whatnot, you know, as if I were going to take it or whatnot. And, like, I got it to run again, and I told him, you know, it was a pretty simple fix, but I also put, like, a screen protector on his Game Boy. It was a Game Boy Pocket. It was a transparent clear one, which was a really cool-looking system. But, yeah, it's all running and everything, and I cleaned up a handful of his games as well to make sure that they ran, you know, fairly decent. But I remember in that slew of games that he had, he had Metroid 2, and I asked him if, you know, he would sell that to me, because my brother used to have it when he was in tech school. And after I fixed up his Game Boy Pocket, he went ahead and gave it to me. And that would be this right here. If you guys haven't seen this, this is actually the sequel to Metroid. This is Metroid 2 Return of Samus. And yeah, we used to have this like a long time ago, and I told him all about it and everything. And I told him also that we also still had the box to it. And it was really cool of him. After fixing his system up a little bit, I managed to, well, he just straight up gave it to me. So now I have a complete copy of the game here. And I guess, like, I dug this out recently, and just to show you here, it's not a colored game by any means, but this here plays quite similar to the one that you find on the Super Nintendo, and is really cool. So this is, if you're looking for the rest of the story of Metroid, this would be it right here. But inside the box, of course, came with this little plastic tray where you place the game in the middle, and then a handful of pamphlets. Since I have this already opened up, I'll go ahead and show you what it came with. See, so, yeah, you can put that on your locker and be the coolest guy in town. But that's actually pretty cool. I didn't even know that this was a poster. I always saw this here. I never opened this. But, yeah, it's actually pretty cool to have this all together again, because this is one of the games I remember playing when my brother came back from Japan. And, he picked this up when he was in tech school, I remember that much, but his first assignment was actually overseas to Kadena in Okinawa, and we were able to get our hands on this when he, after he was done with it and everything, so it's really cool to see that. What was weird is when I was digging this out, I actually came across this, and I knew I had it for a while, but let me go ahead and back this up a little bit. But this is pretty weird, because, yeah, I have these guys too in the box. That would be the original Game Boy, and I'm not sure if you remember, but like the Game Gear and the Game Boy, you know, they would eat up batteries, and this here would be like what you would attach to the side of the game, the Game Boy, and it would let you play the games a little bit longer. It was a rechargeable battery pack. And that was pretty cool. I'm not sure if this one still works, but both of them are complete in there. So I thought that was pretty cool to have all together all again. But the next thing I want to show you guys, this is actually fairly cool. Let me just go, first of all, I told Ken about it, but I was looking for a system on eBay. And I won this one system for, I do believe it was $127. And, you know, I was all psyched. I was like, oh, this is cool. You know, I finally will have this system. But the guy did not come through, unfortunately. It was really hard getting emails back from him. And it took me like over a month to get my money back, because, you know, they have to go through the process of seeing, you know, if the guy actually sent the item and so forth, and he couldn't produce a tracking number or anything. So It went in my favor, obviously, but yeah, I was kind of bummed out about that. And we have a store here called Game Over. You might be familiar with it with like other channels. They talk about it and everything. And I just so happened to go there, and my buddy, I met one of my buddies from college there, and he was one of the Neo Geo guys, that the way I would put it, because there's a handful of us that actually were into Neo Geo at the time, and you know, we were collecting games, you know, building our collections back then, and you know, like, just taking a hit for every game that we bought. But yeah, it was actually pretty cool. I ran into him and I told him my situation. You know, we were just talking about Neo Geo, and I told him about this one guy. I was like, man, you know, this guy, you know, he kind of he didn't come through with his with the auction I had won. So basically, after I talked about that, he was like, you know, if you want one, I'll give you this one for give it to you for $100. I'm like, okay, but he said it was in storage, so, you know, it took a little bit of time to get, but let me go ahead and move this out of the way. I've been staring at that box forever, sorry about that, but I wanted to show you this. Oh, you want to see this again? But he gave me this here for $100, which I think is a pretty cool deal. This here, if you're unfamiliar, this is actually a two-slot Neo Geo MVS system. And the whole reason I wanted to pick up this was I wanted to turn it into a console. And I've been contacting Ken about it, and you know, he was saying, you know, trying to give me a little pointers and stuff as far as things go. And if it doesn't work out, I'm actually trying to hold out, because I know I've seen him with like a lot of people's MVSs, so I want to try to do it myself. But if push comes to shove, he has offered his help, which is really cool. I do appreciate that. And just to show you here, this actually has the built-in controller ports right there. So that takes a lot of the hassle out. And it also has a stereo sound, which can be tapped from the earphones. I do believe the speakers as well, but I think a lot of people do tap from the earphones. And of course, it has the two slots on there. And let's see, the only thing you really need is a video encoder, and other than that, you're pretty much set. You can just do direct taps, and then you have to also alter the thing for 5 volts, because it uses both. I don't know if this works or not, but he offered this for $15 more. This is actually the memory card you would use in the arcade, so if you played your games in the arcade, and you're fortunate enough to have a Neo Geo, you know, during this time when the arcades were like, you know, out and about, you could actually continue your games onto your games at home if you have a Neo Geo. But I don't see the, I guess you could rent the systems too, but yeah, you can play your games. This was the original system that I was familiar with that actually had a memory card, which was really cool. So you could transfer this back and forth from the arcade cabinet to your Neo Geo, and vice versa. So you know, it kept your save progress. Like if you were on King of Fighters, like the third stage, for instance, it would do that. Or you know, any other stage on any game that supported this. But yeah, I guess I'll show you the rest of it. What I did here, it initially had like a wooden board, but I found this one here. Someone was throwing this out at work, and it's actually used for medical purposes. But it has a handle here, so I decided, hey, you know, maybe I could give it a shot and see if it'll drill fairly well, and it actually did pretty well there, where I was able to mount the system on there. I'm not sure if I'm gonna just have holes drilled here, or if I'm gonna make a larger case to go around it, so I won't really tamper with the with this part here. I don't really like drilling through metal. It's not a good experience as far as my vehicle has been concerned. But yeah, okay, just to show you other things here, this is the memory card slot for the memory card, obviously. So you just push it in there. And then we also have another output here. I do believe that's for audio as well, like the headphones, if I'm not mistaken. And then those little dip switches that you see like for arcades and stuff, you flip these. I do believe number 7 there. I think that's for free play. This is my first MVS, so I'm not really too familiar. Of course, you have the two slots there for your first and your second game. And I don't believe there's anything else on the other side here. There are like other ports, I guess. Like if you have attachments here, I do believe that's for like, it says like player 1, player 2. And then this one here just says like EL on there. And then the JAMA type hookup on the front. And there was one other thing. Oh, this guy here, that's the battery. You notice right there. And a lot of people switch this out because it does tend to leak. And they'll replace it with like a coin type battery. And that's probably one of the main things I'll probably have to get done there. But yeah, I thought it was pretty cool. My buddies are actually really cool. You know, I think it was pretty cool to share these stories just because, you know, these people, you know, they could ask for more or, you know, actually charge me, you know, in terms of the Metroid for the game. But, yeah, they were actually cool and hooked me up with these things. And I don't think I could ever find that, like, on eBay for that cheap. So I was really grateful for actually getting a two slot from a buddy. Yeah, those are my stories for today. I thought it'd be cool to share, just kind of keep it separate from the recent finds, just because I think, you know, the stories behind these were actually, you know, a little bit more personal for me. But yeah, thanks again for watching, guys. This is Agent Zero for Yakuza Games, and I'll talk to you guys next time.
Yeah.